just enough space here. First two locks I cut, I didn't quite understand why the cut wasn't the same distance from the center on each end, and now it just hit me, this one is a different. I was measuring from the platform and up, and that's a half an inch, 3/4 of an inch difference from the bunks to the platform in this end compared to that end. Because the ground ain't level, it's higher up down there from the platform. So that's why. Yeah, so now I gotta eyeball it. But yeah, oh, I can count in the half inch on the measurement from the platform. So now it should be spot on. Since it's frost on and off, I empty the tank every night after sawing and fill up with fresh water. I'm adjusting the drop, so I get a drop every 1.5 seconds or so. It's not a shower. Yeah, that's it. And then this. Making sure everything is okay. It was okay when I saw the last time, but yeah. Tensioning the blade as well and see how the tracking is. Yeah. It looks okay. Built got the right tension, nothing, no obstacles or nothing, and should be ready to go. Talk about beautiful floorboards. Looking forward to the day I'm gonna do the floor. I wonder how it goes with the 6m20 lock on this. But it is quite effortless. Yeah. Moving the lock sideways is the absolute most the most labor intense of all the jobs. I guess that's enough. As you can see, I'm close to being maxed out. This is max on this side. But it's because it's cut, it's a root cut. Normally I would, normally you would cut up here somewhere, a meter or 1.5 meter above. But I wanted something that would, with width on it. And I just have to peel off some of the bark. Now I'm gonna flip it. I say that's not quite there because I want a 1.5 inch board as well. Yeah. That should do it. Just enough space. Yeah, close to 7.5 inch in thickness, and 17.5 inch wide. In centimeters, it's yeah, without the bark here, 44 centimeters, and this one is 19 centimeters. I just tried to pick up the board I just made. I couldn't lift it. I had to drag it up to the stack. Yeah, I'm not 25 anymore.
next one ready for transport and a floorboard. Stayed in place, thank God. Free today. After I made that sledge and I'm getting used to the sawmill, it's getting easier every day. And the first couple of days I only produced one because the hassle of getting it up here. But after this, yeah, yesterday I made two, today I have made three. So speeding up the process, that's good. Yeah, I just moved this one from up here and was a bit nervous, but I'm yeah, lucky or unlucky, I don't know, because this one got a big bulk out here because it's a root cut and it's holding up these. So I'll start with these two today, and then yeah, I think this one maybe, I don't know, I'll take a look at that when I get to that point. But for now, it's this one. Yeah, put up a few hinders because one of the locks earlier went all the way, and I don't want those to smash into my platform and into my mill. So it worked. Now I just have to move it a bit and on with the sawing. But today there's next to no wind. And the sun is out and it's dead quiet. I love that. A bit of frost and a light drizzle of snow. Last year we had, this time last year, I think there was around 50 to, at least 50 centimeters of snow. And minus 15, so it's a bit strange with nearly no snow and I don't know, minus 1-2 maybe, or just around 0 degrees. But let's get this lock onto the mill. I do like this setup Johan made for me. That's so, it's so easy to work with the logs, getting them up here. That was it. Brilliant.